We are going to learn about GRU or gated recurrent unit today. This version of RNN is newer than LSTM. This was invented in 2014 and is gaining a lot of popularity. So let's see how this works. You all know that the basic RNN suffers from a short-term memory problem. For example, when you are trying to make an autocomplete for a statement where it says, Dhaval eats samosa almost every day, it shouldn't be hard to guess that this favorite cuisine is. Let's say after is, you want to make a guess. So in order to guess that it's an Indian cuisine, you have to remember samosa. But traditional RNN has short-term memory. So for example, when you are at the statement is, hypothetically, let's assume it remembers only last two words. So when it has cuisine is, it cannot predict that this is an Indian cuisine. It has to remember samosa. So if you have a network like this, which can remember the important keywords, okay? So let's say when I say Dhaval eats, it doesn't remember anything because it's not important. And when it comes to samosa, it remembers that and it carries that long-term memory all the way. Then at the end, when you may want to make a guess on what that cuisine is, you can use that memory and you can deduce that this is an Indian cuisine. Now in last video, we learned about LSTM, and LSTM can do this. It can remember long-term memory. So if you have not seen that last video, please go and watch LSTM video because it will give you understanding on certain concepts. So it has long-term memory and short-term memory. GRU is a modified or a lightweight version of LSTM where it combines long and short-term memory into its hidden state. Okay, so you see the basic difference. LSTM has two, like cell state and hidden state. Here it has only hidden state, which can combine both long and short-term memory. If you look into GRU box, it will have two gates. LSTM had three gates, input, output, and forget. GRU has only two gates, update gate and reset gate. And the function of update gate is to it knows how much of past memory to retain. Whereas reset gate knows how much of past memory to forget. Now they sound a little similar, but actually there is some subtle difference and we'll look into it using an example. And there is certain other mechanism which I'm going to show. And then in the end, you get like output as well as output hidden state. So let's go back to our original NLP problem of completing an English sentence. So when you have a sentence like this, of course, the answer is Indian. You might have seen Gmail, right? When you type something, it tries to autocomplete. So we're trying to solve the same problem. And it knows that it's an Indian cuisine based on this word, samosa. But when you have a longer statement like this, where you start a second statement saying that his brother loves pasta and cheese, then the answer of this autocomplete would be Italian. So now watch this carefully. What happens is when you are until this word, okay, when you are say cuisine is, then you want to remember about samosa. Because you have that much in context, okay? And when you go further and when you come here till pasta, now you know the context has changed. So when it comes to pasta, you want to forget about samosa, okay? Similarly, when it comes to cheese, you want to retain the memory of pasta. So now you already see kind of the difference that here you want to forget about samosa when pasta comes. But when you want to go to and cheese and words like that, you want to retain the memory of pasta such that you can autocomplete it saying that it's an Italian cuisine. So in GRU, now this cell that I'm showing you is GRU. The first thing is when pasta comes, you want to forget about samosa. And the way it is handled is using a reset gate. A reset gate takes hidden state ht-1 and the current word xt, and it will do this mathematical operation like weighted sum, applied sigmoid activation on top of it, and the RT value that you get is your reset gate value. When it comes to cheese, for example, you want to retain the memory of pasta, and same applies to the word AND, okay? And that is done by update gate. So what update gate will do is exactly same as reset gate, but it will have different type of weights. Like if you look at this mathematical equation, this WZ, like previously it was, you see WR. So the weights are different, but mathematical equation is still same. Weighted sum of XT WZ, HT minus 1 UZ, and you apply sigmoid activation. So ZT that you get here is the value of your update gate. So far it looks a little simple that you are taking update gate value and reset gate value. Now it gets a little bit complex. You will use this value ZTRT and then HT minus 1 XT to produce your new hidden state as well as your output. So this is how the final GRU looks like. Here, this multiplication operation that you're seeing is Hadamard product. So it's a product between two matrices. And if you look at the Wikipedia article on you know, you can search for Hadamard product. You will see you have two matrices and it's just taking element by element and just, you know, multiplying them. A1, B1, 1C, A1, B1, and then A1, 2, B1, 2, you see, A3, 3, B3. So element wise element product. And if you look at the mathematical equation, they look like this. So I know it's a little complex, but maybe you can consume this information. You can look at this mathematical equation and you kind of get an idea on what this is. But overall, the crux of this whole GRU unit is it combines short-term memory, long-term memory into one state, and it is a little bit lightweight than LSTM. So let's see the differences between the two. So LSTM has three gates, GRU has only two. LSTM is more accurate on longer sequences. It takes little more time or little less efficient. There are cases where they both perform equally well. But GRU is overall more efficient computation-wise and it's getting more popular. It was invented in 2014 and LSTM is a little old. It was invented between 95 and 97 and GRU is gaining more popularity. So I hope this video gives you some understanding of GRU. This was all about theory. In the future, I will try to cover coding as well. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends who want to learn about GRU. Thank you.